How does the order of antibodies in my multiplex IHC panel affect staining results? And how can I optimize my antibody panel? I'm Jen, Senior Research Associate at Cell Signaling Technology, and this is CST Tech Tips. The protocol we recommend for fluorescent multiplex immunohistochemistry, or mIHC, uses a serial staining strategy where each antibody is incubated with a sample one at a time, followed by deposition of a tyramide-based fluorophore to enable detection. If you missed our mIHC overview video, click on this pop-up link in the corner to see an animation of how serial labeling works, and then come back to this video. And if you find tech tips informative, take a second to give this video a like and subscribe. You can also find more expert advice on techniques, getting published, and navigating a career in science at cellmentor.com, a resource for early career scientists from Cell Signaling Technology and our friends at CellPress. In this video, I'll refer to each primary antibody incubation step as a slot and a collection of antibodies as a panel. Your goal in mIHC is to obtain a balanced set of signals from all of your antibodies while also accurately reporting the biology in your sample. In the course of your research, you may decide to create new combinations of antibodies in your multiplex panel. This can present challenges because some antibodies perform well in both early and late incubation slots, while others do not. To illustrate why this may be a problem, let's consider a multiplex panel with six labels and look at the epitope for the first label in your panel and compare it to the last epitope. Before the first labeling slot, the sample is subjected to an antigen retrieval step by boiling in a microwave for 10 minutes. This helps the antibody to access its epitope in the sample, and it's also routinely used in single-stain IHC. So, the epitope for your first labeling slot will experience 10 minutes of heat time by the time its antibody incubation step occurs. Then, after the tyramide fluorophore complexes are deposited, the antibody is stripped or removed from the sample, again with a microwave heating step. This process is repeated for each antibody, such that epitopes for later labeling slots experience more heating rounds. So, in the sixth labeling slot, the sample has been heated six times for a total of an hour before this epitope ever sees its antibody. The implication of this situation is that an antibody that performs well in chromogenic IHC may have lower than expected signal in multiplex IHC, even with tyramide amplification. This is dependent on how sensitive the epitope is to degradation by heating and how sensitive it is to epitope masking, a phenomenon which I'll define later in this video. When receiving a new antibody for use in mIHC, you can evaluate epitope sensitivity by performing a mock protocol with serial tissue sections or cell pellet samples with known expression. Each of your test samples will go through all the heating steps in your protocol, depicted in red in this diagram. You'll stain samples with a single primary antibody, secondary antibody, and fluorophore, depicted here as blue, green, and orange, but apply them in different heating slots for each test. So, what can you expect to find when testing for sensitivity? First, some epitopes may be more tolerant, exhibiting low sensitivity to heating. Antibodies to epitopes in this category may be placed in any order in the panel. Other epitopes demonstrate moderate sensitivity to heating, resulting in gradual decrease in signal intensity with each additional round of stripping. Some epitopes will exhibit high sensitivity with a quicker loss of signal. These targets should ideally be stained early in your panel. This graph shows the fluorescence intensity of PD-L1 staining in positive and negative cell pellets. The PD-L1 staining was much brighter in the last slots compared to the first two, possibly due to the epitope becoming increasingly exposed during each round of heating. This is an example of an antibody that actually benefits from being stained in a later slot. Now that we understand epitope degradation, let's define epitope masking. This can happen in mIHC when two or more of your antibodies detect targets expressed in the same subcellular compartments of the same cell types. Tyramide deposition from the first antibody can blanket nearby epitopes, reducing the signal of subsequent antibodies in your panel. In this mIHC analysis of a metastatic tumor in mouse lung, CD8 staining in red is largely exclusive of CD3 staining in green. Because we would not expect a majority of CD8 positive T cells to be CD3 negative, this suggests epitope masking is taking place. One potential approach to resolve epitope masking is to switch the order of the primary antibodies. In our example, moving CD3 first in the staining order was able to restore the expected overlap between CD3 and CD8. If switching antibody order doesn't successfully resolve your epitope masking problem, you can try titration of the primary antibody, titration of the tyramide fluorophore conjugate, and/or optimizing incubation time for either or both of these. We also recommend performing single staining in parallel with the multiplex staining to ensure that there aren't significant increases or decreases in the number of cells staining positively for each protein of interest. Ultimately, the order in which each antibody is placed in the panel is an interplay between the epitopes and the fluorophore's sensitivity to heat, the expression level of the target, and the degree of target colocalization that may increase epitope masking. By isolating and optimizing each antibody and better understanding each epitope, antibody, and fluorophore in your panel, you can improve your ability to generate publication-quality mIHC data. Thanks for watching. If you have questions about a CST antibody or protocol, you can get in touch with a scientist at cellsignal.com/support. For more Tech Tip videos, subscribe to our channel and click the bell to get notified when new videos go live. We'll see you next time. Good luck with your experiments.